Whoa, new setting. Actually, it's an old setting. True fans will remember.
Flashback.
Hey! We'll save that one for a sneezing video.
End of flashback.
I wanted to show off the star chart wall tapestry I have in my room. It's phosphorescent, so it glows in the dark. If it absorbs enough light and I turn off the lights, it glows. Let's get to the psychology. In my last video, I talked about the early roots of the field of psychology. Philosophers, doctors, scholars, writers, and thinkers all ask questions about how the mind works. Today, we're talking how psychology became a scientific discipline. So many people continued to question how the mind works over centuries and continents and disciplines. There was growing public interest in studying the mind in Europe. It was amidst this growing interest that German professor Wilhelm Wundt established the first psychology laboratory in 1879. This was at the University of Leipzig in Germany. Within 2 years, in 1881, he launched the first scientific journal on psychology. The creation of his lab marked the birth of psychology as an independent field of scientific study. One of his students, G. Stanley Hall, started the first psych lab in the United States at Johns Hopkins University. This was in 1883, and after him, there was a boom of 24 new psych research labs opening up across the United States and Canada within a decade. Academia doesn't exactly have a reputation for quick changes, so this is very impressive. Hall also established the American Psychological Association in 1882, which today is the world's largest psychological organization. A lot of these labs were established by students of Wundt, and they studied extensions of his ideas. This included structuralism, which focused on the structure of the mental experience. Just like physicists study atoms and subatomic particles to understand matter, structuralists tried to reduce the mind down to its core components, like specific images, sensations, and feelings. They didn't have brain scans or anything like that at the time, so they relied on introspection, in which subjects were trained to carefully observe and record their experiences. This is great, but you can probably already catch on to some flaws in this method of study. First of all, introspection is very subjective. How you describe your feelings of anger or happiness may be very different from how I would describe mine, which makes it difficult to draw reliable or valid conclusions from this method of studying. Another flaw is that reducing mental experiences down to their individual thoughts and feelings can easily miss the bigger picture. There was another school at the time that said, "Don't worry, we got you, we have a solution for that." The Gestalt school of psychology famously claimed that the whole is greater than the sum of its parts. This was called the principle of totality. One example they showed was this illusion. You don't just see the three little Pac-Mans, your brain will also notice a triangle between them. But the triangle isn't there, hence an illusion, which goes to show that the whole is greater than just the parts that you see. Perception is more than what meets the eye. Everything is not what it seems. Another school of psychology that was around at the time studied the function of thoughts. Appropriately called functionalism, this school was greatly influenced by Darwin's theory of natural selection. Like wings or opposable thumbs, our thoughts and behaviors must have some kind of function for natural selection to have selected them. For example, our stress response may have helped us escape dangerous situations, and our craving for sugar could be a reflection of what we ate as hunter-gatherers. These are all adaptations that can help an organism survive. Functionalism studied the why rather than the how of psychology. And that's how psychology became a scientific discipline and some of the early schools that studied it. You may have noticed that I've been including timestamps in all of these videos so you can go back and review the concepts accordingly. Just make sure you're ready for the quiz. I'm just kidding, there's no quiz. But if you want to use this content to study for your psych exams, I wouldn't be mad. That's it for today's video. Next week, unfortunately, we're talking about Freud. Don't like that man. Be sure to hit that subscribe button for new videos every single week. And remember that science is everywhere. Gestalt.